Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be all about my 6 tips to keeping your handbags hygienic during this crazy pandemic. I know a lot of you guys are staying home at the moment, so I'm sure a lot of your handbags are just having a long deserved break, but I'm sure you do need to go out to the supermarkets to do some groceries or just, you know, a few things that you need to head out for occasionally. Or if you are like me, you might still be working. So I have cut down my hours, but my line of work, I am in healthcare, I am a full-time dentist, so we haven't closed completely just so that we can facilitate and help out with dental emergencies, so the whole healthcare system doesn't get burdened even more with dental emergency patients. So we have really reduced the amount of procedures that we do because there is always going to be aerosols created in dental treatment, but the dental practice that I work at, we are still open to see those emergency patients. So I still need to go outside of my house a few times a week. So my handbag routine and contents have completely changed now that we are living through this crazy time. We need to make sure everything is hygienic and everything is clean as soon as we get home. And even when we're outside, we're trying to keep our belongings nice and clean and make sure that it doesn't touch unnecessary surfaces. So I thought it might be actually helpful to share a few tips that I do to keep my belongings clean while I'm out and about and what I do when I get home. And I'm also going to show you what handbag I'm carrying at the moment. It is not what you expect, but it will do the job. So watch right till the end if you do want to know what bag I'm carrying currently. Before we get into the 6 tips, if you're new here to my channel, welcome. My name is Isabel. What better time to join my YouTube family than now, because I'm sure a lot of us have a lot of free time, so we could all do with a bit of light distraction. So if that sounds like something you'd like to do and you do generally like fashion and luxury, I'm sure you'll find my videos enjoyable. So if that's you, I'd love it if you consider subscribing to my channel by just clicking that red button down below and press the bell button next to the subscribe button as well, because then YouTube will notify you every single time I upload a new video. And I do intend to upload more videos now that I have a bit more time on my hands since I have cut down my work hours while we wait for this pandemic to settle down a little bit. So yeah, with that out of the way, let's get into the very first tip. So my very first tip is to use your phone to pay for things. So whether it be Apple Pay or your banking app, these days it is so easy for you to store your card information on your phone. So whenever you have to pay at the grocery store or whatnot, you can just use your phone. I'm not sure whether that works for other countries, but in Australia, we do have a tap system. So you don't actually have to touch the tap pad on the card machine, but you can kind of hover the phone or your credit card over the top of the tap area. That way, every time you have to pay for something, you don't have to pull your wallet out, touch your wallet, grab your card out and pay for it, put it back. And when you're out and about, your hands are so dirty and you definitely have some germs on your hands. So I definitely recommend storing one of your credit cards or debit cards on your phone so you can pay on your phone. And this ties in with my next tip, which is when you return home, you just wipe down every single thing that is going to be alcohol resistant with an alcohol wipe. And not every single thing that you have in your bag you'd want to put alcohol on. So for example, your nice designer wallet, you don't want to put alcohol on that. And that is why I say try and do as much as you can on your phone, because I completely have no hesitation when it comes to wiping my phone down with that alcohol. So if I minimize the amount of things that I touch in my bag, then it also reduces the number of things I have to disinfect when I get home. So typically when I'm out and about these days, I try to really only touch my phone and my car key. I wish I actually had keyless entry to my car, but my car's a few years old and at the time it didn't have keyless entry option for that specific model. So I still need to grab my car key and put it into ignition. So I definitely need to spray that down when I get home. And that's the other thing. I used to carry my car key on my Louis Vuitton 6 key holder and I stopped doing that because I don't want to have to touch my nice 6 key holder with my dirty hands to get home and then to have to disinfect the nice 6 key holder. So now this just stays home and I just just pull out the keys that I need, and generally I don't need the keys every single day. So now I just carry the car key on its own. Because it is steel and plastic, I can just wipe it over with alcohol wipe. And if you're wondering what I'm using to wipe those things down, I use these two. So this is just 100% isopropyl alcohol, and you can just get this from any hardware stores or stationery stores. I'm not sure how easy it is to grab anything with alcohol in it these days because people have just panic bought everything, but I've already had this in the house, which was really handy. So I spray a little bit of it on a makeup removal cotton pad, and then I just use it to wipe down my phone and my car key. And the other great alternative is just the pre-made lens cleaner. So this also has the alcohol in it. They come in individual sachets. So I actually carry this around to clean my prescription glasses with. So this is another great option if you can't find the 100% isopropyl alcohol. So that is what I do as soon as I get home. Anything that is going to be durable enough to be wiped down with alcohol wipe, I just do that as soon as I get home and let everything dry before I let them touch any surfaces in my house. The third tip I have to keep things in your bag nice and hygienic is to just use a Ziploc bag instead of your nice wallets. I am sure a lot of you love your nice designer wallets as I do, but at the moment, again, you want to use something that is completely wipeable. So that is the theme of this video. I just want to be able to wipe every single thing down that I've touched with my hands while I'm out and about without washing my hands. So yep, I completely don't even use a wallet anymore. I keep cash in one of these Ziploc bags. You don't always have to throw it out, but because it is just a plastic bag, what you can do is use the same alcohol wipe to wipe this down as soon as you get home. It's nice to be able to pay for things on your phone with your debit or credit card on it, but sometimes you just need a bit of cash to pay for things. So I do like to always carry a little bit of cash with me. So that is the other thing that I've been doing, is to just keep cash in a Ziploc bag and no wallet. My fourth tip is, and this is where I reveal the bag that I've been using lately, is just to use a washable cotton bag. This is a cotton bag that I've had for years, and it is from Cotton On. It is actually quite cute, isn't it, really? And because I love jeans, it kind of works with all my outfits. What I do these days is I have a couple of these, and every time I use this bag, I empty the contents, disinfect the contents, like I said, and I literally wash this every single time I take it outside. I know it could be going a little bit overboard, but I feel like we just don't know enough about this whole virus situation and why it's so infectious. So I just rather be safe than sorry. Call me crazy, or hopefully you agree with me. But anyway, so I've just been using this bag, and you know what, guys, I've been really loving it. It is so lightweight, it is so worry-free, and I just realized I don't really need a designer bag. And that is not to say that I'm not gonna buy any more designer bags, or, you know, really let go of all my designer bags. Of course, I absolutely love my designer bags, but I'm really realizing a lot of luxuries in life, they are just that. They're just luxuries and you don't really need them. And when time comes that you need to really not have them, I'm completely okay with that, which was always my mindset. But yeah, I've been really, really enjoying this washable cotton eco bag. So that is what I would recommend that you do as well if you are as paranoid as me. My fifth tip ties in with this tip is, if you are using a non-washable bag, any of your designer bags or any of the other bags that you can't just put in the washing machine, what I recommend is that whenever you return home, you just put it in one corner and quarantine the bag. So you leave it in one corner and you pretty much don't touch it for about 3 days, and rotate through your other bags, and each time you take another bag out, do the same thing, and after 3 days, you touch it. And I say this because they haven't tested all surfaces, but the longest time that the virus has been reported to be able to survive on a surface is 96 hours. I think it was on metal surface or cardboard, something like that. So I'm just gonna be safe and not touch the bag surface, which is leather or canvas or nylon. I don't know if virus can live on it or how long it is viable for, but again, crazy me, I'd rather be safe than sorry. So I'm just gonna quarantine my bag in the corner of my house somewhere and not touch it for 3 days. And after that, there should be no viable virus left on the bag, so go for it. You can touch your bag again. And I would never recommend using alcohol wipes or anything on any of your nice leather or canvas bags. So quarantining my bag for about 3 days gives me the peace of mind that it will be clean and safe enough to touch it after 3 days. So that will be my next thing if you are really pedantic like me. And my last tip is just to wash your hands really regularly wherever possible. Wash your hands before you reach for the contents in your bag, and when you're out and about, just really minimize the amount of contact your bag has with outside surfaces. You don't know who touched it, who was infected, and you just don't want to take that chance. So wash your hands for 20 seconds. They say if you sing happy birthday, that should be long enough for 20 second hand washing. Make sure you get in between all your fingers, make sure the soap is leathered up really, really well, all of that stuff that you already know. So this might be a really obvious point, but I just feel like there is nothing more effective than just keeping your hands clean, because at the end of the day, you're the only one really dealing with your handbag other than when it needs to sit somewhere. So I also wouldn't recommend leaving the bag on any of the surfaces, just have it on you at all times. It's just that this whole thing is just unprecedented. We've never really lived through these uncertain times before, so I really rather be safe than sorry, and this is why I've been doing these 6 crazy things. And I thought maybe it'll be fun and useful to share these things with you if you are kind of similar to me. So yeah, these are the 6 very simple things that you can do to try and keep your bags and their contents as hygienic and clean as possible in this crazy time. If you've got other tips on the topic, do share them in the comments below, because sharing is caring, especially in this time. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And as always, thank you so much for watching and spending some of your precious time with me today. And I can't wait to see you again soon in my next video. Bye guys!